हेलो चिल्ड्रेन, सो लेट्स कंटिन्यू चैप्टर नंबर 5 मल्टीप्लिकेशन। चिल्ड्रेन, टुडे वी विल सी एक्सरसाइज 5.7। सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 इज एस्टिमेट द प्रोडक्ट बाय राउंडिंग ऑफ द नंबर्स टू नियरेस्ट 10। सो वी हैव टू फाइंड द प्रोडक्ट, एस्टिमेट द प्रोडक्ट बाय राउंडिंग ऑफ द नंबर्स टू नियरेस्ट 10। सो द नंबर, क्वेश्चन नंबर ए इज 49 मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 83। सो चिल्ड्रेन, फर्स्ट वी विल राउंड ऑफ नंबर 49 टू नियरेस्ट 10। एंड वट विल बी द राउंड ऑफ ऑफ 49 टू नियरेस्ट 10? सो यू जस्ट लुक एट द डिजिट एट द वंस प्लेस विच इज 9 हेयर। सो वट विल बी द राउंड ऑफ ऑफ 49 टू नियरेस्ट 10? इट विल बी 50, इजंट इट चिल्ड्रेन? एंड नाउ लुक एट द सेकेंड नंबर विच इज 83 हियर। सो वट विल बी द राउंड ऑफ ऑफ 83 टू नियरेस्ट 10? लुक एट द डिजिट एट द वंस प्लेस चिल्ड्रेन, विच इज 3, विच इज लेस देन 5। सो वट विल बी द राउंड ऑफ ऑफ 83 टू नियरेस्ट 10? इट विल बी 80। ओके, नाउ वी हैव टू फाइंड द प्रोडक्ट। सो वी विल मल्टीप्लाई 50 बाय 80। So children, there you can see the number of zero. How many zeros are there? 2 zeros are there. So first we will write these 2 zeros here. And now we will multiply the remaining digits. So what are the remaining digits here now? 5 and 8. So 5 8s are, or 8 5s are 40. So that also we will write here. So what will be the estimated product? It will be 4,000. Got it children? This will be our answer. What did we do? We rounded off the numbers to nearest 10 and then we multiply to get the estimated product. Got it children? Now let's move to the next question. So question number B from the same question number 1 is 76 multiplied by 52. So first we will round off 76 to nearest 10. So what will be the round off of 76 to nearest 10? Look at the digit first at the ones place here children, which is 6, which is more than 5. So what will be the round off of 76? It will be 80. Whereas the round off of 52, now look at the digit at the ones place of 52, it's 2, which is less than 5. So what will be the round off? It will be 50, that you can see here. Now we'll find the product. We will now multiply the rounded off numbers here. So how many zeros you can see here children? You can see here 2 zeros. So first we'll write these 2 zeros here. And now we'll multiply the remaining digits. So what are the remaining digits now? 8 and 5. So 8 5s are 40. So what is the estimated product here? It's 4,000. So this is our answer children. Got it? Now let's move to the next question. Now question number C is 98 multiplied by 65. So first we will round off 98 to nearest 10. So what will be the round off children of 98 to nearest 10? Look at the digit at the ones place. What is the digit there? It's 8, which is more than 5. So what will be the round off of 98? 90 or 100? Yes, it will be 100. Why? Because the digit at the ones place is 8, which is more than 5. Now look at the second number here, which is, or multiplier here, it is 65. Now look at the digit at the ones place here. It's 5. So what will be the round off of 65 to nearest 10? It will be 7070. Now let's find their product. So what will be their product? 100 multiplied by 70. So dear children, how many zeros you can see? You can see here 3 zeros, 1, 2 and this one 3 zeros. So first we will write these 3 zeros, 1, 2 and 3. And now we'll multiply the remaining digits. So what are the remaining digits here? 1 and 7. So 1 7s are, or 7 1s are 7. So what is the estimated product here, children? It's 7,000. Got it, children? Now let's move to the next question. Now question number D is 114 multiplied by 28. So let's round off the numbers to nearest 10 first. So to round off the first number, which is 114, look at the digit at the ones place, children, which is 4, which is less than 5. So what will be the round off? It will be 110, isn't it, children? Now look at the other number, the multiplier here, which is 28. So look at the digit at the ones place here, which is 8. So what will be the round off of 28 to nearest 10? It will be 3030. Now let's find their product. So we will multiply here 110 multiplied by 30. So how many zeros are there? First we will write the number of zeros. So 1 and 2. And now we will multiply the remaining digits. So 1 3 is a 3. Again 1 3 is a 3. So what will be the round off, children? What will be the estimated product? It will be 3300. Okay, children? Now let's move to the next question. Now question number 2 is, children, estimate the product by rounding off the numbers to nearest 100. In question number 1, you have to round off the numbers to nearest 10. In this question number 2, you have to estimate the product by rounding off the numbers to nearest 100. Now we have to round off the numbers to nearest 100. So question number A is 361 multiplied by 226. So first, let's take the first number or multiplicand here, which is 361. Now, because children, we have to round off it to nearest 100, so we will look at the digit at the tens place here. And in 361, what is the digit at the tens place? It's 6, which is more than 5. So what will be the round off of 361 here? Yes, it will be 400, that you can see here written. And what will be the round off of 226? Look at the digit at the tens place here, which is 2. So what we will do? We will write 2 zeros at the ones and tens place, and then we will write 2 at the hundreds place. So the round off of 226 to nearest 100 would be 200. Now let's multiply to get their estimated product. So how many zeros are there, children? You can see 4 zeros are there. So first we will write those 4 zeros. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And now we will multiply the remaining digits. So what are the remaining digits here? 4 and 2. So 4 2s are 8. So what will be the estimated product here? It will be 80,000. Got it, children? Now let's move to the next question. Now question number B is 472 multiplied by 594. So first let's round off 472 to nearest 100. So children, again you look at the digit at the tens place here in 472. So the digit at the tens place is 7, which is more than 5. So what will be the round off of 472 to nearest 100? It will be 500. And now look at the multiplier here, which is 594. So look at the digit at the tens place here, which is 9. So what will be the round off of 594 to nearest 100? It will be 600. Now Let's multiply to get their estimated product. So how many zeros are there, children? You can see 4 zeros are there. So first we will write these 4 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4. And now we will multiply the remaining digit, which is 5 and 6 here. So 5, 6 are 30. So what is the estimated product here, children? Yes, it's 3 lakh. Got it, children? So 3 lakh is the estimated product of 472 and 594 when the digits are rounded off to nearest 100. Now let's move to the next question. Now children, question number C is 716 multiplied by 119. So let's round off 716 first. So first, children, you look at the digit at the tens place, which is 1, which is less than 5. So what will be the round off of 716 to nearest 100? It will be 700. And now you look at the multiplier here, which is 119. So look at the digit at the ones place. The digit is 1, which is less than 5. So what will be the round off of 119 to nearest 100? It will be 100. Now let's find their estimated product. So how many zeros are there, children? You can see 4 zeros are there. So first we'll write these 4 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4. And now we will multiply the remaining digits, which is 7 and 1. So 7 ones are, or 1 sevens are 7. So what is the estimated product, children, that we get here? It's 70,000. Now children, question number D is 2841 multiplied by 154. So children, let's first round off 2841 to nearest 100. So children, to round off this number to nearest 100, look at the digit at the tens place, which is 4 here, which is less than 5. So what will be the round off of 2800 here? It will be 2841. The round off will be 2800 that we have written here. You can see, children. Why? Because the digit at the tens place is 4, which is less than 5. So we will write 2800. We will write 0 at the ones and tens place, and then we will write the digits at the hundreds and thousands place as it is. Now look at the multiplier here, which is 154. So look at the digit at the tens place here, which is 5. So what will be the round off of 154 to nearest 100? It will be 200. Now let's multiply to get their estimated product. So children, how many zeros are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 zeros. So first we will write 4 zeros. 3 and 4. And now we will multiply the remaining digits here. So what will be the product here? So 8 twos are 16. So 6 we will write here. And 1 will be carried over to the next place. Now 2 2's are 4 plus 1, this carried over 1, 5. So what will be the estimated product here? It will be 560,000. Got it, children? So in this way we find out the estimated product of the given numbers. Okay, children? Now These are some practice questions that you will do on your own. You will practice for all these questions in your notebook. Okay, children? So, children, that's all for today. Thank you.